Greetings and a warm welcome. Today, science and technology has become an integral part of our life. And indeed, we can't imagine our lives without technology. As we scan through the pages of history, many scientists have contributed to this steep growth, especially in the 20th century. As we focus on the land transport with the invention of wheels, we have been moving in carts, and now, do you recognize what is this? Yes, we talk about the levitation trains moving without any friction at a speed of about 600 km per hour. The underlying phenomenon is just the Meissner effect exhibited by superconductors. Oh, what are superconductors? Why should they be referred super? As the name suggests, they should be superior in current conduction. Conductors are the materials which transport electrons very easily. At this juncture, I invite you to reflect on the differences between resistance and resistivity. We know as resistivity is independent of dimension, in order to understand the variation with temperature, we do plot resistivity and not resistance along y-axis. For ordinary metals, referred as good conductors, resistivity decreases with decrease in temperature. This is because as the temperature decreases, the lattice vibrations gets decreased, reducing the scattering of electrons and thereby facilitating electrons to travel faster through the lattice. Thus, lesser the scattering at low temperatures, lesser is the resistivity. As we reach 0 Kelvin, we have still a non-zero resistivity, which is referred as impurity resistivity, well known by the Matheson's rule. Now, superconductors are very special category of materials whose resistivity drops down to almost zero at a temperature well above 0 Kelvin, known as the transition temperature TC. Thus, below TC, the conductivity is extremely large, and so the phenomenon is named superconductivity. They find extensive applications in lossless power transmission, magnets producing very high magnetic fields, and extensively used in the field of medicine in magnetic resonance imaging, MRI scans, and to evaluate extremely weak biomagnetic fields originating from different organs in magnetocephalography, magnetocardiography, and liver susceptometry, using superconducting quantum interference devices referred as SQUIDs. Yes, superconductors have really revolutionized the whole world, but yet economic grounds built boundaries for extensive use, and still researchers strive to prepare superconductors with TC close to room temperature. If so, it will topple the whole world upside down. Hope you understood what are superconductors and how important they are. Thank you for your attention.